So the band had just finished this world tour with Bob Dylan. This was a distraction, actually, when we hooked up with Bob. And we thought, all right, well, it's going to be just this tour, and then, you know, we'll get back to where we're going with all of this, our own music. Albert Grossman, and he had said, you guys should come up to Woodstock. You could get a place up there. Nobody will bother you. You can make all the noise you want. You can do whatever you want. We find a place up there that we think this is the clubhouse. This is the workshop. Some of the guys can stay there. We can set up, and it had been a dream of mine for a long time to have a place where we could create, we could figure out, we could write like a real workshop. Well, the house was just an ordinary place, but it was in the middle of 100 acres. And for that, the freedom that it made us feel, and that the isolation and the privacy, and it was just a dream come true. So this house had a few bedrooms in it where some of the guys could stay. Very, very normal. It's actually a bit hard to describe it because there was nothing about it that was very much to look at, really. But it had some furniture in it, and it accommodated the situation perfectly. But it was pink. And that was, you know, that was a joke. So we called it Big Pink as a type of a joke. But the basement was this setup. All of our instruments were there, and we were all in a circle, and it just felt like this was meant to be.